I felt the need to clear a few things up about my marriage.
No, honestly. It's like a broken record.
About the fact that I've so often been shut out, left to cope on my own, and that I've suffered from a lack of sympathy and feeling and compassion.
Haven't we heard all this before? 1,000 times. Haven't we read it in newspaper articles 1,000 times? Does it not occur to you that if you feel the need to clear a few things up, a public forum might not be the best place to do it? That such matters would best be discussed in private with the people involved?
I've tried that.
When?
On numerous occasions over the years, I've asked to see you so that we might talk face to face, and on every occasion, you refused or were unavailable.
I accept it's not easy navigating this family. And I can understand why you might think we're all a bit remote. But there is another word for remote. Busy. We are all busy people with busy diaries, rarely under the same roof for 2 nights at a time. And none of us, not one senior member of the royal family, has a spare 10 minutes to think about themselves, let alone you, or how we might best make your life miserable. On the contrary, it might surprise you to learn we all spend a great deal of time doing the opposite. Because when people, armies of people, say to me, what has that girl done now? Who does she think she is? What do you imagine I say? Oh, Lord, yes, Diana's awful, a nightmare. What a mistake that was. Not once. Not a single time. Your wife to my eldest son, mother to my grandsons, and a valued senior member of this family. So I defend you each and every time, loyally, emphatically, to the hilt. The enemy you imagine I am, the hostility you imagine we all feel, is a figment of your imagination.
Is it?
Yes. All any of us want, Diana, is for you to be happy. And one day to be our next queen.